Welcome back, everyone, to Wildly Opinionated, and this is a cause for celebration because this is the maiden voyage of our new Wildly Opinionated studio. And by studio, I mean the corner of my apartment room that I set up this table and all of this random crap. Studio! But yeah, this is awesome. I have not done something like this in about 2 months because I've been trying to focus on getting a job and graduating from Texas A&M University, which I did. I did that with a bachelor's degree in wildlife and fishery sciences, and now I'm working somewhere on this planet Earth. There's a crack in this. There's a crack in this globe. I just spent $15 on this at Target. I'm upset. But anyway, yeah, so just graduated, which is why I haven't been doing a whole lot of stuff for this podcast, but, you know, that's not important now. Now we're back to podcasting, because I'm, like, an adult now, which is really weird because, there's only, like, an 83% chance I'm wearing pants under this desk, for one, and two, like, I'm stupid, so, also, I have three more of these, so I'll probably just pop them off at random times during the podcast. But go ahead and follow us on Instagram and Twitter at wildly, is it wildly underscore? I think it's wildly underscore podcast. Yes, it is. On both Twitter and Instagram. You can find us on Facebook if you just search Wildly Opinionated Podcast. Check us out if you're watching this on YouTube. Check us out on Spotify, Apple Music, SoundCloud, Google Play. And if you're listening to us, go ahead and check us out on YouTube. Subscribe, give us some reviews, email us at wildlyopinionated@gmail.com for questions, comments, concerns, or if you just like my shirt, you know. I think that's all. Oh, Patreon. It costs me about $16 a month to host this, which is not much, but it'd kind of be nice to, I don't know, get some of that back so I can start focusing on buying more stuff for the podcast, like more microphones, better cameras, maybe building a better studio. So if you guys want to support, you know, it only takes a couple bucks or a donation or something like that. Not going to beg for your money, but I don't have any sponsors yet. So if you guys want to help us out, make some cool stuff, that would be cool. But big news, I am kind of changing up the podcast. So Wildly Opinionated is your source for random wildlife discussion, but over the course of the past couple years, particularly the past several months, my life has been about a lot more than wildlife. I'm very passionate about wildlife. I love talking about it on this podcast and in my life. My career is in wildlife. My schooling is in wildlife. Most of my passions and interests are surrounding wildlife and nature. But I think there's a lot more to life than that. And there's been a lot more to my life than that lately. And I want to talk to you guys about it. And I feel like Wildly Opinionated, you can focus on the wildlife aspect, and you also just focus on the opinions and critical thinking and just seeing different perspectives on a lot of different things, because the world is all about perception and different perspectives and the way you see things. And if you can broaden that, just like traveling, you can make your mind travel through hearing other people's opinions. And if you travel to other countries, like we talked to with Brighton Prashlika about all of his travels, he learned so much through the cultures and the things like that. You can also learn that just by hearing other people's opinions and facts and stories and jokes. And so I kind of want to do stuff like that. I want to widen the range. We'll still talk about wildlife. I still will do my random animal fact at the end of every show. It will still be called Wildly Opinionated. I have tons of wildlife topics ready for you guys, but I want to pepper in some other things. Fitness, mental health, there's tons of different things we could cover, and I have tons of interesting people I can think of or I had lined up to come talk about stuff like that. So today, I want to talk about change. So this obviously is a pretty big change for us. I got to come up with a new slogan because we're no longer your source of random wildlife discussion, and your source for random discussion is okay. I may play around with some other slogans first, but whatever. But basically, What I want to talk about is kind of why change is so scary and why change is so weird and why it's hard to embrace, but it is good to embrace it. Over the past, it's been 2 years, or almost been about a year and a half, I guess. If you saw my last video about my niece and her battle with cancer and how she passed away and how we've been trying to honor her memory from that, you kind of know about this. If you haven't, or if you're listening, go check out that video. But my life was pretty normal. Normal family, normal, no one was sick, normal life, normal school, normal friends. And then my niece got sick and things started changing, and then she died and things started changing a lot more. And then I was dating this girl, and we had been dating for 2 years. We planned on getting married, and then we broke up, and we tried to get back together a couple times. And there's no bad blood or toxicity there, but it's been difficult. And then I'd never struggled with depression before. I'd never struggled with anxiety before. I'd never struggled with serious insecurities and self-doubt before. And a combination of my niece and suppressing feelings and about to graduate college and uncertainties about the future and that breakup and just milestones. You know, it would be Sophie, my niece's death anniversary, or her birthday, or Christmas without her, or first Christmas without this girlfriend since we had broken up, or recently I realized that we were planning on getting married around this time of the year, around, you know, after I graduated college. And getting used to that and getting used to the change of my new job and my new city and my new situation and being okay with being single and changing from having my niece here to having to honor her memory and grieve and mourn for her life, but honoring her in death, it's been interesting and it's been sad sometimes, it's been beautiful sometimes, it's been helpful sometimes. I've learned a lot. I've always been a relatively smart guy. I'm not a genius, but I've always been able to do okay in school. But I feel like I've actually gained some wisdom and perspective lately, and it's made my life a lot better, and it's gotten me through some deep holes, because as good of a support group as people can have, if you have a great family, if you have a great significant other, if you have great friends, if, you know, whatever, sometimes you have to figure things out for yourself. And that's the crazy thing, is that this change, everybody can give you advice, but you have to figure it out your own. I had a friend who just kept going back to this toxic girlfriend. She treated him poorly, she was mean to him, but his first love, he kept going back to her. And I kept trying to tell him, like, man, just stop, you know what you're doing, like, that's awful, you're hurting yourself. And he had to figure it out on his own. Because you can tell people so many things, but you honestly just can't, you know, do things for them. And that's just how it works. And I know I'm this 22-year-old dude fresh out of college, and what do I know about life? There's plenty of stuff I need to learn. I'm ignorant in so many different things, but I've also learned so much in my 22 years, and particularly since I was 19 or 20. I've learned a ton. I've made mistakes. I've done things right. I've done things in between. I've thought about making mistakes, and fate has saved me from it, or stuff like that. I've blacked out drinking, trying to get over grief. I've hitchhiked down a highway in the rain at 3 a.m. I've helped talk someone out of suicide. I've done things. I've hung out with my friends instead of going out and partying. I've gone to a party with my friends instead of sitting at home watching TV. I've tried new sports. I've tried new shows. I've started playing music again and drawing and trying to learn new art and exploring new places and learning new things. Change is good, but it scares the ever-living dog crap out of people, including myself. I'm scared of, like, five things. Ladders, change, sharks, zombies, and kind of cows, honestly. We'll get into it later. Cows, silent killers. They're more, whatever. But, basically, embracing change is the hardest thing I've ever had to do. Well, one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. But comfort is good and all, but you have to be able to find comfort in a lot of different things. You have to find comfort in being uncomfortable. I loved my high school. I'm not one of those guys who's like, oh, take me back. You know, we go state my senior year, dude. I'm not like that. But I loved my high school. I had great friends. I had a good community. I loved everything about it for the most part. So I was scared moving on to Texas A&M. I came from a class where it was a public school, but I only graduated with 27 kids, including myself. Then coming to A&M and moving 3 hours away from home was a big deal, and away from my friends and my family that I was so close with. And then I spent 4 years living at Texas A&M and really getting into that culture and getting in my groove and meeting new friends and meeting people who make my soul happy and who fulfill me. And I found a purpose, and I was doing what I wanted to do and what I liked to do, and I was comfortable. And so I didn't get hired on this job until April 22nd of this year. And I graduated May 9th. I didn't have an apartment until May 13th. And I started work May 20th. I didn't have a roommate until May 13th. And you know what? It's been great. I love this change. I love things, and you know, I don't entirely love my new job. It's something. It's a starter. It's a good job, and I enjoy it. It's not what I want to do forever, but I enjoy the change, and I enjoy the experience, and I enjoy making more than $8 an hour part time, like I did for the past 4 or 5 years, because I can afford to leave this light on for more than 30 minutes at a time. But it's an incredible thing to embrace change and to know that it's scary, but to do it. My favorite John Wayne quote is, courage is being scared to death, but saddling up anyway. And that's got me through a lot of stuff, which is kind of insane to think that some words from an old Western actor could do that. But it's kind of like that thing. If you're about to do something scary, you know, like a roller coaster or jumping off of a diving board, you just count to three and then do it. And that's kind of like, I was comfortable in College Station. I had a part-time job. I had internships I could have gotten with university. I could have gone straight to grad school. Like, I plan on going to grad school in 2020. But I felt like my path was to get out, and I felt like my path was calling me here. And for those of you who are religious like I am, or I would honestly say I'm more faithful / spiritual than religious, but that's a different topic for a different podcast. You could say that it's God putting me on this path. For those of you who find, you know, you believe more in fate or the universe or cosmic energy or feng shui or giant lizard people, then it's just something was pushing me towards this, and I think I'm going to be a lot better for it. So not to be this corny self-help guy, but this change, I've seen it affect so many people in positive ways. I had a couple friends from my small town who I thought were going to waste away with the same girlfriend or the same boyfriend or the same job or the same living in the same house or living with their parents or living in the same town. And once they made a change, I saw them just bloom. They photosynthesis the heck out of their freaking lives. And it was amazing. And I don't know. It's just, I could go on and ramble about this, because the thing that I do when I speak is I make a point, and I'm like, there's a different way I could say that, but I say the same thing just in different words, and I'm like, oh, my voice is so amazing, I love hearing it. But, you know, we're not going to do that here, especially because I think my camera's about to die. But the moral of the story is, well, really the moral of the story is, I'm super wise and amazing, and you guys are peasants, and you should listen to everything that I say. So, no, I'll save that one for later. No, legitimately though, basically the moral of the story is, life is going to kick you straight in the freaking face, dude. Like, sometimes you're just gonna get like the 1-2 rat-a-tat-tat, the freaking Hong Kong fooey right to your dome. Like, you're gonna get noggined, you're gonna get wasted, it's gonna be rough. And for some people, it's gonna be, you're gonna handle it one way. For some people, you're gonna handle it another way. Some of the people who've been going through this stuff that I've been going through lately, or who are a part of it, or a cause of it, or a symptom of it, or an effect of it, or whatever, they've handled things entirely different than me. Some of them are still dealing with things. Some of them have gotten worse. Some of them got better quicker. Some of them have handled things way different. Some of them had to do really stupid things and cope in a toxic way to realize that they hated it and to go to a healthy way. Some of them have been doing it healthy the whole time. Some of them embraced the change. Some of them resisted. Some of them found the happy medium. So you gotta find your own thing. And not to say, like, I know this is kind of a dumb, motivational, self-help, inspirational episode of the Wildly Opinionated podcast, but it's such an important thing to learn how to think critically and handle life and to be successful. I want all of you to be successful. I want to be successful. I want you to guide, and not successful as far as, like, having this cool setup for your podcast, or, you know, having this $15 slightly damaged globe that you bought from Target today, or millions of dollars, or whatever. Some people are fine with living in a 3-bedroom house and having a kid and settling down and doing their 9-to-5. Some people hate that. Some people like office jobs. Some people like commission. Some people like doing tons of different things. Finding that thing, and finding that success, and finding happiness is such a big mission for me right now. It's crazy. I've been obsessed with it. Because I'd always been happy, but I'd never been challenged. I'd never been changed. Or at least not much. Not to the extent that I have been. And now that I've been challenged, and I've been unhappy, and I've seen what that's like. I've seen pain. I've seen heartbreak. I've seen longing and anxiety. But I've also seen the joy and the victory and the accomplishment. And I have so much more left. And whether you're 8 or 88 or 8,088, if you're 8,088, you're probably like a dragon person living off of the souls of the wicked. So you probably shouldn't even listen to me, because this is, you probably have your own thing figured out by now. But young or old, whatever stage of your life you're in, you can always find a way to do what you need to do. And even if you have what you want, or what you need, or what's fulfilling, there's ways to improve it, or there's ways to sustain it. And I'm in the middle of that. And a lot of you are in the middle of that. Like, I know some of my older family members in the middle of that. They're 60 or 50, or friends, or 35 or 40 or 25 or whatever, figuring things out. And I'm excited about what's coming next. I'm excited about this job. I'm excited about doing the best I can. I'm excited about the next job. I'm excited about grad school. I'm excited about the job after that. I'm excited about the next girl that comes along. I'm excited about getting a puppy at some point. I'm excited about what I'm going to eat for lunch tomorrow, which is going to be a banana, a breakfast bar, peanut butter crackers, tangerine, and a Colby Jack and oven roasted turkey sandwich on 100% wheat with some V8 diet fruit juice. It's going to be delicious. Maybe throw in some fruit snacks. It's going to be like great, dude. And also, if you're listening and not watching the video, I know that was an awkward pause. I was just doing hand motions. So you literally didn't miss out on anything. But yeah, that's all I got today, guys. I wanted to kind of talk about change and what's been going on in my life with stuff like that. And I'll get into the depression and the dealing with grief, and I've touched on that with my niece and the video I made for that, but the dealing with depression and dealing with insecurities and anxiety and dealing with heartbreak and dealing with treating people right, because, like, I don't know, my ex and I don't treat each other like crap. Like, we're nice to each other, but some people are toxic for each other, and that just wasn't the case in this situation. So there's tons of different things that tons of variables. It's literally infinite that can go on, and it's super interesting and super freaking like, oh my god, dude, what's gonna happen? And then you just, you know, checkmate your life, and it's just, it's gonna be cool. You guys are gonna figure, oh, drop something. I'm gonna figure my life out, and it's gonna be freaking wicked. Like, it's gonna be gnarly, righteous, radical, tubular, and other words that stereotypical 80s surfers use. But, like, I'm gonna figure my life out. And my life's, I'm gonna figure out what my path is, and I'm gonna follow it, and I'm gonna trust that it's good, and I'm gonna trust that I'm doing good, and it's gonna be crazy. And you guys are gonna do the same, or you're doing it right now, and that's awesome. Like, it's legitimately beautiful. And, you know, I would love to hear experiences and talk about it with you guys, either on here or on through an email or through a message or just in person or whatever. Would love to hear that. I love hearing those perspectives and those stories. but yeah, that's really all that I have. So welcome to the new and hopefully improved Wildly Opinionated podcast. It's gonna be wild. So, you know, with work and stuff, we're gonna figure out Bonner's life. And I'm going to tell you about it. So, that's about all I got for you. Go ahead and follow us on, like, literally everything. Instagram and Twitter. You know, you got @wildly_podcast. Make sure to use the #wildlyopinionated or #wildlypodcast. Find us on Facebook. You can add me personally @TheBonnerLaid on Instagram and Twitter. You can find me on Facebook. Email us at wildlyopinionated@gmail.com. Send us your stuff. Donate on Patreon. Be a patron. I'll give you a shout out. I'll send you stickers. Stuff like that. We'll be friends. You'll support me. I'll use your money wisely most of the time. Subscribe, comment, review. I don't know. Just like do something. And that's not saying that you aren't doing things. People are doing things. You've been very supportive. But yeah, just do stuff. So I'd like to thank our sponsors, which are me, myself, and I, and the United States of America, and the Viking blood that runs through my veins. Anyway, this is about the time in the podcast where I'm going to start rambling, so I'm going to go ahead and end this, but thank you so much for listening to the Wildly Opinionated podcast. For now, your source for just random discussion.